Hello everyone, welcome to ANAT AV. This video gives a detailed description of the morphological appearance and the structural composition of the skull vault. When viewed from above, the skull vault is usually oval in shape. It is wider posteriorly than anteriorly. The vault consists of the upper part of the frontal bone anteriorly, the uppermost part of the occipital bone posteriorly, and a parietal bone on each side. Now let's identify the joints or the sutures that separate the above bones. The coronal suture is placed between the frontal and the two parietal bones. The sagittal suture is placed in the median plane between the two parietal bones. The lambdoid suture lies posteriorly between the occipital and the two parietal bones. The bregma is the meeting point between the coronal and sagittal sutures. The lambda is the meeting point between the sagittal and the lambdoid sutures. Let's move back to the skull vault. The parietal foramina, one on each side, pierces the parietal bone near its upper border. The parietal foramina each transmits an emissary vein from the veins of the scalp to the superior sagittal sinus. These veins are significant as routes of spread of extracranial infections to the intracranial venous sinuses. Laterally on the vault are the temporal lines that begin at the zygomatic process of the frontal bone, arch backwards and upwards, and cross the frontal bone, the coronal suture, and the parietal bone. Over the parietal bone, there are two lines, superior and inferior. The pterion is the area in the temporal fossa where four bones, the frontal, parietal, temporal, and sphenoid, adjoin each other across an H-shaped suture. Deep to the pterion lies the anterior branch of the middle meningeal artery, the middle meningeal vein, and deeper still, the stem of the lateral sulcus of the cerebral hemisphere at the sylvian point, dividing into three rami. The pterion marks an especially thin area of bone, which is prone to fracture in blows to the temple. Fractures here lead to extradural hemorrhage, typically of the anterior branch of the middle meningeal artery. This compresses the motor area, resulting in contralateral hemiparesis.
In the fetal skull, bregma is the site of a membranous gap called the anterior fontanelle, which closes between 18 to 24 months of age. The lambda is the site of the posterior fontanelle, which closes at birth or within 2 to 3 months of age. The other two fontanelles consist of a pair of sphenoid fontanelles found anteriorly and a pair of mastoid fontanelles found posteriorly. So what are fontanelles? They are the spaces between bones of the growing skull which permit the growth of the brain and also help to determine the age of that particular skull. A clinical significance of the anterior fontanelle is that if it is bulging, there is raised intracranial pressure. Conversely, if it is depressed, it shows decreased intracranial pressure, mostly due to dehydration. Posteriorly, you can find the external occipital protuberance, which is a median prominence in the lower part. It marks the junction between the head and the neck. The superior nuchal lines are curved bony ridges passing laterally from the protuberance. These also mark the junction between the head and the neck. Let's have a look at the internal surface of the vault. The inner table is thin and brittle. It presents markings produced by the meningeal vessels, venous sinuses, arachnoid granulations, and to some extent by the cerebral gyri. It also presents raised ridges formed by the attachments of the dural folds. The frontal crest lies anteriorly in the median plane, and it projects backwards. The sagittal sulcus runs from anterior to posterior in the median plane. It becomes progressively wider posteriorly, and it lodges the superior sagittal sinus. The granular foveoli are deep, irregular, and large pits situated on either side of the sagittal sulcus. They are formed by arachnoid granulations. The groove for the anterior branch of the middle meningeal artery and the accompanying vein runs upwards 1 centimeter behind the coronal suture. Smaller grooves for the branches arising from both the anterior and posterior branches of the middle meningeal vessels runs upwards and backwards over the parietal bone. The impressions for cerebral gyri are less distinct. These become very prominent in cases of raised intracranial pressure. That brings to an end this video on the anatomy of the skull vault. If you enjoyed this video and found it helpful, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Please share this video with your friends and anyone interested in the study of anatomy. Thank you for watching ANAT AV.